that was a long flight. 17 and a half hour flight. I'd say it was worth it though. Definitely worth it. We're on top of the Marina Bay Sands Hotel in Singapore. Believe it or not, we're not just here on holiday, we're actually working very hard because it has one of the highest rates of lightning strikes in the world. And it's currently November at the time of recording this, which is the most active month for lightning strikes. Should be a very interesting subject to film. I've never filmed lightning. It's incredibly fast, incredibly unpredictable. Also very dangerous, which makes me wonder why we're on the roof. Yeah, well, thankfully there's no storm in currently, but why don't we set up the phantoms in a nice safe location and wait for a storm to roll in?
In a bit.
In a bit. Here we are in a hotel room looking out at the Singapore skyline. Today we're using a Phantom V2512. We often use the 2511, but this has much more internal memory, 288 gigs.
And we can usually record, what, like 4 seconds with the...
2 seconds.
2 seconds.
This will record almost 8 at 28,500 frames a second. But we're going to be running this slightly differently to how we usually shoot, in that I'm going to firstly partition the RAM into multiple segments, and I'm also going to use a feature called image-based auto-trigger. What do you know about it?
It sounds like, because it's automatically triggering it, that you're out of a job.
Well, sort of. Let me run you through it. So the first thing I'm going to do is we typically only use one partition in the memory. We can record for the whole thing. This capacity allows us to record for almost 8 seconds. And because of the duration of a lightning strike, we don't need 8 seconds. So it's actually more beneficial if we, say, get 8 different partitions, giving us around a second for each capture. So what I've done is I've set this little area, this little box. See the red box?
Yep.
And then I can set how often it checks and the sensitivity of how big the pixel change has to be for it to register a trigger. And then I can position this box wherever. So I'm gonna bung it on the sky. That way anything down here, you know, people taking pictures or anything like that shouldn't affect it. But if lightning comes down through the top, it should trigger the camera, automatically save that 0.9 seconds into the mag, and just immediately go again.
So you're saying that if it sees lightning, it will save it for you?
Yeah. And now, in theory, if I change, if I mimic some lightning here.
Yeah.
What'd it do?
Immediately triggered and then stopped, and it's recording again. It went, there's a solid circle, and then it started recording
again. So it went one, and then when I turned it off, it went another one. And you can see now it's immediately recording into the mag.
Oh yeah, so because it was so quick, when you did it, it went 2, 3, like that, it was immediate. Wow.
So this is pretty much set up now. So now all you need to do is wait for it to become nighttime or wait for a lightning strike, and it should capture and save automatically until it's completely full. So now we just wait.
But wait, if it does everything automatically, should we just... Pub?
Pub.
Hotel.
You're gonna miss all the lightning.
I'm sure the lightning's currently striking on the bayside. Look at the ocean, so we've got another room up this end.
We could have been opposite,
but we were so well set up in the other.
Go, go, go. Oh,
sorry.
No glass over here.
Also have to pardon our sound quality. The sound guy went home.
About half an hour before this started as well. We had him all day. Oh, did you see that one?
Good. Fuck.
looked like there was nothing there, then you saw like a lot of boats. The brightness. Wow.
Yeah, you can see completely. It's even though it's night time and we're taking 28,000 frames a second, it's completely blowing out the battery. And it's
our,
like
our exposure time is only one,
it's 17 microseconds. 17 millionths of a second. And it's completely blown out the camera. That's insane.
Like,
okay, it looks like a new.
What?
Shut up.
I like the thing about this automatic triggering is you know exactly when the event's going to happen as well.
Yeah, we've got trigger points in the middle, so you just scroll to that.
Oh wow, it's cool because that one has like three separate forks of feelers.
Yeah.
It's like almost like three different bits of lightning. Only one of them hit really.
God, it's so bright. It's immense. You see, it just struck the ocean. Just hit the water.
That's incredible, but like...
That's a fish that's going to be annoying.
So these ships that are just sort of there, they're not even getting hit really, it's just the ocean is getting hit.
You know, if ever we're struggling for light, we should just get some of this stuff.
Oh, that's a free frame right there.
That's a thumbnail.
Yeah, that's a thumbnail.
Wow.
That's so cool.
And this frame rate, it's an odd frame rate. We're just picking the maximum frame rate we can do at 720p.
Yeah.
But it's almost perfect. Like, it's the perfect speed.
Yeah. So it should be, I wish, if you could see in slow-mo, I would like to take bets on which feeler. Actually, like, you could be like, take bets halfway through and be like, I think it's this one.
Oh,
yeah.
Second one.
Yeah, it was like a secondary doobie.
And then after that, another one comes out.
So that one
must have extra gear.
Yeah.
That. Twin strike.
I actually remember seeing this one in real life. I remember that one. I do. I was like, oh, that was a good one, a doubler. And you were just stood there with the camera like, blah, 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 not even like paying attention.
Oh, whoa! Holy cow!
He should have filmed that again.
Jesus!
Yeah, that was...
It's close.
That was insane, that one.
Bugger!
That was quality!
Alright, I think I caught one at 103,000 frames a second.
Really?
And I think it was right down the middle. You ready?
Yeah. It's getting rowdy.
Okay, here you go, you ready?
Yeah.
I think the main bolt was somewhere else, but that
these were the side bolts.
That is like the side feelers. Look at the speed on that.
Wow. It's like video game lightning.
Yeah.
It's like way slower video game.
That's class.
Alright, it appears the storm is subsiding, but we've got over 60 takes of lightning, so I think we can call it there. Go inside.
Well, that was some absolutely beautiful footage. I'm so relieved we got it. And just so relieved we actually have had a lightning storm, because imagine coming all the way to Singapore for no reason. That would suck. That would have been the worst.
I also have a massively newfound respect for lightning. I mean, I knew it was dangerous, right? But
God.
It made those ships look like little toys in like a bathtub.
It looks so scary. I was so fascinated to see the difference in speed between all the feeler forks compared to the big, bright strike.
Yeah.
Absolutely insane.
Completely blew it out, didn't it?
Oh, that was a really fun video to make. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Feel free to subscribe, check out part two, where we're gonna learn more about lightning and Dan's gonna get shocked.
What?